Hey guys, welcome to Lara Tips. From today onwards, we'll be starting a new series where we'll be creating an e-commerce website. And I have made just a simple database structure for this e-commerce website over here. And this is not yet completed. But now I am thinking that I will be recording this as I am making. I'll not complete the whole series and then start recording it. If I do it, then I can just grab some of the ideas from you guys that I can implement in this e-commerce website. And I'll be implementing those if many of you request. And this series is sponsored by Cloudways. More on them later. So here, let us just look at some of the database structures. And if you are wondering about this node, this is just the Notion. I'll be leaving the link of this note just below that like button, this text editor or note, whatever you want to call it. So by default, we'll have this users table on the Laravel, and we will be using Laravel 9, Inertia.js, Tailwind CSS. And in the Inertia.js, we'll be using Vue.js. So this will be our tech stack, and we'll be deploying our project in the Cloudways. So here, let's see, we'll have this users table. So everything is same as that of the default Laravel. And we'll be using Laravel Breeze for authentication. We have just added this type, but I'm also thinking of adding roles and permission to this series, because in my previous series, I didn't add that. Many of you asked for that, but I didn't add that over there. But I think I'll add roles and permission in this series. So this field might disappear whenever we get started. And now I have these categories. And we'll be only using two levels of categories, but I'll design this database structure so that we will be able to create as many levels of categories as we can. And if you don't know how to create multi-levels of categories, then I have created 3 videos on this. You can watch those videos, and I'll be leaving the link of those videos just below that like button. So the structure, the database structure is same as I have discussed in those videos. Now here in the product, we have ID, name, or you can tell title, slog. This is what will appear in the URL of the product detail page. Then we'll have description, then cost price, and this is the price. So this cost price is whatever the price that costs to the seller. And this price is whatever price he or she want to sell it. Then featured, we'll also have some boxes in the home page, and we'll show some featured products over there. And we'll also have show on slider. And whenever this is true, then we'll show these product in the slider. And active means whichever active that will only be shown in our front end. And created and updated are present in every one of the models. And this is the pivot model, so category ID and product ID. A product can be related to the many categories or subcategories, so I have created a pivot table for this, and we'll create a model category product, which will be a pivot model. By the way, we can also create a pivot model, and I'll be showing you how to use this when we will start the series. And we'll also have this coupon, and I think we'll only add percentage, but if you want, then you can also add discount amount as a coupon, not only the percentage. And here we'll have this order. Whenever user adds products to the cart and submit, then we'll just generate the order, and this UUID will be the tracking ID of the order. We'll not show this ID to the user, we'll show this UUID as a tracking ID. Then the tracking will be pending, cancelled, completed, refunded, etc. And if there can be any other statuses, then just let me know in the comment section below. And I haven't created e-commerce website before, so I don't know what are the fields that is needed, but by seeing the common e-commerce website, I think this will be enough. Then shipping will be a JSON column, which will include all the shipping addresses. Then we'll have completed add. If this order is completed, then we'll set this to the timestamp whenever the order was completed. Whenever we use this kind of timestamp field for the completed status, then we'll know that the order is completed, as well as we'll know when that order was completed. So it will give us 2 informations. Then we'll also have cancelled add. If the order was cancelled, then it will be set. And I forgot to add here coupon ID. So we can also add here coupon ID. It will be integer, and this will be foreign key to this coupon, and it can be nullable. And similarly, the last thing that is over here is order product pivot model. So by this, we can just get all the products that is in a particular order. And I have added here cost price and price, because in the future, if the cost price or price of a product changes, then it will not reflect in our previous orders. Suppose let's say if a product price was 100 and it changed to 110 in the future at a specific time, then if we don't write this cost price and price, then we have to derive this cost price from this product, and in all the previous transaction it will take the new price. So in order to fix that problem, I am writing here cost price and price over here. And regarding the roles and permissions, we'll use SPASI roles and permission package. And these are the only things that came into my mind whenever we are creating an e-commerce website. And for the payment option, I think we'll use either PayPal or Stripe or both. I don't know. Let's see what we'll do. And I have also done CRUD for categories and users, and I want to show you that, but we'll be developing that from scratch from the next video. So here the website name is ecommerce.test, and this is the dashboard, and this dashboard part we'll be building in the end. So here users, I have these filters, and this new users, we also have this pagination. So I'm only showing this pagination for the three users, but we'll be adding 10 or 20. And in the filter, we will just, let's say if I write here admin, then it will only search for the admin. And if I just do here select, then it will search for all the selects. And if I show you here in the users controller, then we'll just pass this thing, filter items like input select like this, and it will automatically construct this filter for us. So we'll be learning how to do this, which itself can be a separate video, but I'll be including that in this series. Similarly, if you look here in the category also, I am just passing this, so yes, no, select and input. And if I come here category, and you'll see here name, active, and this root category, and this is yes, no, select, and this is the normal select. And if I just click here 5, then it will just assign that to this root category, and it will find the children of that category. So in this series, we'll only be doing two levels of categories, but as I said, you can do any levels of categories. And we can also edit and delete. So here I am here in the users, I can just click here in the edit, and I can edit that user. I can also delete this user. We'll also create this model. And also we will be able to sort these. We'll be making component for each and every one of these. So this table component will automatically sort and show the paginations. This will be the filters component, which will automatically convert this thing into these UI, where we'll be using the dynamic components of Vue.js. So I hope you'll enjoy this series, and also let me know what are your thoughts on this. And finally, whenever we are doing this series, we'll be deploying this project to the Cloudways. And thanks to Cloudways for sponsoring this whole series. Cloudways is a managed cloud hosting platform which focuses on your business and avoid all the web hosting hassles. Cloudways will take care of the server setup for you, and you can go live in minutes using the Cloudways. You can select any one of these applications like WordPress, Laravel, PHP, etc. And you can host those in any one of these server like DigitalOcean, AWS, Vulture, Google Cloud, or Linode. And also you can scale your server size as you need using the simple and easy user interface. You can use the link below to subscribe to Cloudways. And if you do so, you will get $15 as a credit. And you can use that $15 to set up a base server, and it will last you almost a month, which means that you are getting 1 month free. So thank you for watching. Have a great day. Bye.